get down.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the national anthem performed by the Marshwood High School Concert Band. Principal of Marshwood High School, and it is my pleasure to stand before you on this glorious evening and welcome all of you to Marshwood High School's 41st commencement. The first thing I'd like to do is acknowledge all the staff and the faculty of Marshwood High School. I wish to publicly thank all of you for all you do. You are the reason Marshwood is a great place for everyone to learn. I also want to thank the members of the Board of Directors, the community members at South Berwick and Elliott, and the parents of our students that provide us with a tremendous amount of support that allows us and allows our students to be so successful. Now for the class of 2008. I never thought this day would come. Over the course of this week, I've been pondering the words I would use tonight to present to the class of 2008. Many thoughts rattled around in my head, and I attempted on several occasions to get these thoughts to paper. My thoughts became clearer as I found myself spending more time with the members of the class at marching practice, senior banquet, and convocation. As I looked around from senior to senior, I found myself remembering many moments, colorful moments, that came together to create a mosaic in my mind of the class of 2008. There is a piece for everyone in the class. 210 pieces, the largest Marshwood mosaic ever. When I look at this mosaic in my mind's eye, I see the success, the leadership, and the fun that makes up the class of 2008. I see a shot put being thrown farther than any other female Marshwood athlete. I see two national merit finalists. I see 5 full scholarships to colleges for academic success. Woo! I see an infamous quote. It is interesting. School is easier when you try. I see actors in a swimming pool in the auditorium. I see someone taking a dip in a golf course pond in the dark. I see ecstasies on the sound and whiteboards. I see a group of girls from the flatland skiing faster down a mountain than anyone else in the state. I see the film I Heart San Francisco. I see the goodness of a community vegetable and herb garden. I see quality work in a flagpole flower garden. I see craftsmanship in a shaker style end table. I see a student representing their peers on the district's board of directors. I think I may even see a president of the United States. I see a fashion designer. I see a four-time state champion in wrestling. I see the emergence of dynasties in field hockey, baseball, and softball. I see over 300 scholar-athlete certificates. I see a new cross-country course record. I see Godspell. I see an act of sportsmanship in a girls' playoff lacrosse game. I see cabarets and coffee houses. I see spring fling and a wetness glint. I see so much more in the class of 2008. I could go on, but handing out the diplomas will take long enough. As I stare at this impressive mosaic, I hear the sounds of many songs played and sung by the class of 2008. The lyrics of Greener Side's song at convocation seem to come through loudest. Now we are finally free of this place. Now it's our turn to go on our own way. We can start it all over today. The class of 2008 will undoubtedly go. They will go all around this world and make their marks. And from the song sung at Senior Assembly, what a wonderful world it will be. I present to you the class of 2008. My pleasure to introduce to you the salutatorian of the class of 2008, Colleen Fitzpatrick.
face a struggling economy, unaffordable oil prices, and rising sea levels. Much of the world still lives in a perpetual state of poverty and warfare. The victims of unstable regimes, religious intolerance, or a simple lack of resources. But here in America, we have the technology, the knowledge, and the capital to make the world better. All we need is the drive to do something about it. It is essential that we retain our desire to change the world, even if it seems impossible. Keep believing that you can do anything, that the universe is yours. Have a goal, an aspiration, a great expectation. As Henry David Thoreau wrote, if one advances confidently in the direction of his dreams and endeavors to live the life which he had imagined, he will meet with success unexpected in common hours. So go for it. There's nothing to lose. We have the ability to create our own reality, to forge our own path, to refuse to be enslaved by doubt. We can't let ourselves be held down by the notion of the real world, but must look instead to the possibility stretching across the horizon. Our lives start now, at this moment, and nothing can hold us back. So I urge you, push the boundaries of the possible, embrace your newfound freedom, and change the world.
With the president of the class of 2008, Samuel Flingstrom, please come to the stage and present the class gift.
For the past 3 years, I've served as president of the class 2008. And boy, what a 3 years they have been. At times, presidential tasks were a little daunting, but I, as well as my fellow class officers, never saw them as chores. With their help, as well as the rest of the class, being president was an enjoyable experience. Whether it be selling Yankee candles or making cotton candy at the Strawberry Festival in really hot weather, many of the graduates here today have contributed in some way to the success of our class. As we drift away from our days here at Marshwood, and our individual contributions are no longer necessary, it's time to come together to leave our mark as a class. To do so, I'd like to welcome our class treasurer, Kevin Krikas, to the stage to help me present the class gift to Mr. Melhorn. Our gift to the school is this check, which is to be added to an existing account whose funds will be put towards an electronic sign at the entrance of our school.
Now to present the Director's Book Awards is the Chairperson of the Board of Directors, Ms. Colleen Cass.
Good evening. I'm once again honored to be able to represent the Board of Directors and congratulate the class of 2008 and welcome all the friends, families, and neighbors of our graduates. The first thing I'd like to do is just recognize our school board members. Susan Puller, Martha Lee, Ralph Stevens, Tom Flanagan, our newest member, and Vice Chair Ellen Breed. I will make this very brief, but I just want to mention that tonight is really a night when we celebrate successes. And I think every one of you has one, if not many, many members who are watching you here tonight who have contributed to the success. Teachers, parents, friends, grandparents, someone who has helped you and supported you along the way. But along with the emotion of outside our community are letters saying what special students we have. When we have been asked by a number of visiting committees, what are we most proud of? The answer is always, very quickly, our students. And so I'd also just like to tell you that tonight, everybody watching you here, whatever path you are choosing to follow after tonight, we are very proud of your success. Now I have the honor of presenting the Board of Directors Book Award. And these are awards presented in different academic areas. And they are chosen, the recipients are chosen by members of the faculty. And these individuals have been chosen to receive these awards because they have demonstrated particular enthusiasm and dedication in the specific academic area. So we will begin in the academic area of English. The title and author of the book is Empire Falls by Richard Russo, and the recipient is Stephen Higgins. Fine Art. The book is a photography book by Faden Press, and the recipient is Patricia Holmes. In the career technical area, the book is Robotics Demystified, a self-teaching guide by Enwin Wise. And the recipient is Ronald Pearson. In the area of music, the American Songbook by Finally, in the area of family and consumer science, the invention of Hugo Cabret by Brian Selznick, Caitlin Baffrey. Congratulations and much success to every member of the class of 2018.
We may look at the class of 2008 and measure some of their success by the amount of the financial award that has been provided from various sources to this class. It is a whopping amount. The class of 2008 has earned $996,200 in financial award. Congratulations. To introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2008, Stephen Higgins.
As I sat down to write this speech, in days that seemed to be more Florida and less Maine, I realized how many topics there are to cover when one tries to sum up 4 years of high school at Marshwood. I thought I might talk about how much we are a class of individuals, as was said as senior assembly, until I realized, here we all are, wearing the same purple gowns, the same purple hats, and the same purple chairs. I considered defining a word like perseverance or success, until I realized, not only is this overdone, but no single word can begin to do this class justice. We are the largest class to have ever come through Marshwood High School. We were the first class to spend both fourth and fifth grade at the now renamed Great Works School, and we faced the spinning ball of death together in seventh grade. In eighth grade, we were denied our trip to Boston since the teachers decided our grade would be boiled down into the good kids and the bad kids. Once more. While we cannot all run for president or became famous activists, we can help out a little ways. Don't fear the failure of a cause. As Nelson Mandela said, after 27 years in an African jail for advocating equality, the greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. So I challenge every member of this class to get out, do anything and everything until the last days of your lives. Give back to your community, to your family, your friends, and your faith. Know that we are given a life that millions can only dream of, and it is a waste to take it for granted. Never stop giving, no matter what, and know the world has no obligation to you, but rather, you have one to the world. Always think of those around you and how you can make their lives better, one act at a time. Live your life to the fullest, as we only have a short time on this earth. As oversaid as all these things are, they are only cliché because they are true. So after all that, I will leave you with one last thought. As you go on through the rest of your life, remember those who have always been for you these past 4 years. These are the people that will be with you for the rest of your life. But at the same time, also remember those who are not always there for you. For it is from them that you can grow and will continue to grow the most. And oh yeah, try to remember what greener side is. I have a feeling we'll be seeing them in a few years. Congratulations, class of 2018. It's been a long 4 years, but we made it. Love to whatever life brings.
David Gratian and the Marshwood High School Concert Band playing Kirkpatrick Fanfare by Dr. Andrew Boyson. Thank you. moment we've all been waiting for, the conferring of the diplomas. Presenting the diplomas to the members of the class of 2008 is Dr. Jeffrey B. Bearden, Superintendent of Schools. Martinez. Jillian Alicia Moscone. Justin Moscone. Thank you. Rebecca Tabula Pickett. Jocelyn Marie Will. Michael Cooper. Alexander Matthew Sapier. Sean Patrick Snow. Ha ha ha. Mike Campbell. Benjamin Allen. Yeah. Caitlin, and Patchkey. Danielle Marie Davis. Elizabeth Marie Burdick. Eileen Elizabeth Sterling. Patricia Hollings. Spencer Blake. Courtney Rose Raymond. Gabriel Woodlock. Ryan Walker. Guthrie Allen Johnson Barr. Timothy Hutchins. Jacob Mayo. Jacob Leslie. Travis James. Justin Daniel Dabrowski. Pacheco. Sergeant. Samantha Jules Robeson. We'll beat it. Christopher Jackson. Gabrielle Pete. Covington. Jonathan Gunn. Jonathan Hussey. Taylor Kress. Donna Rose Long. Anthony Delane Richardson. Okay, folks, we're almost there. A little bit longer. Ian Michael Garcia Grant. Natalie K. Weaver. Christina Noel Fallon.
Alicia Maria Bukavalis.
Jossie Kearson. And now, to give the farewell address to the class of 2008, Jacqueline Ruggier Fenton, John Thompson, and Matthew Valancourt.
Thank you. humble thief to experience high school moment. And all we can say is goodbye. Goodbye to Miss West's bubbles and Mrs. Watts' shining aid pluses. Farewell to Mr. McGregor's don't nod like a duck. And Mr. Pearson, step into my office. No more overhead vegetables in the cafeteria. No more finishing homework before the morning bell. No more coffee houses. No more marine bio field trips. Now there will be no more bells. Deadlines will be extended to midnight. Schoolwork will be more intense. But transitioning isn't a change for the worse. You'll have more opportunities to socialize at parties or any sort of event. You can still perform in bands and vocal ensembles. You can still form clubs and small groups with discussions that range from politics to Harry Potter. And you can even tour Europe in groups and share laughs over shopping and a few scoops of gelato. Don't think there's nothing in college. High school has many opportunities. You could have presented at a science conference that you do attend as a summer program. You could have earned a part in professional theater just by loving the stage. You could have earned a pulp and paper scholarship by having a dream for engineering and ignorance for pulp and paper. And you can still pursue those opportunities. Imagine what college will have in store.
Mr. Grish.